Hey guys, this morning we're going to make some AWR buttermilk biscuits. Real simple to do. It's really three ingredients, but we added an extra ingredient to help make it a little more fluffier. So let's get at it. Hope you enjoy. It's going to be delicious, I guarantee. We'll be right back. Alright guys, our four ingredients, we've got, of course, buttermilk. We have self-rising flour, one stick of butter, and our extra ingredient that we're going to add is baking powder. So I'll get with that, here in a second. But it's real simple. Take your flour, got a 1 cup measuring cup here. And you want to add 2 cups of self-rising flour. Whisk that up a little bit and break up the big chunks. We got a spoon. Alright. We're going to add just 1 teaspoon. Teaspoon now, not a soup spoon or serving spoon. About that much. Add it in there. Right. Sift it up again. Get it all mixed up real good. Incorporated in there. Alright, we're going to take our butter. And we're going to cut it up into pieces. We're probably going to use about we're going to leave about 3/4, a little less than about 7/8 of a stick left. I'm just cutting it up in squares. It's going to take a little bit of time, but man, these biscuits, since I started making these, they've got better and better, and I don't make them that often. That much butter left over, but we're going to be using this later on. So alright, now that we got our butter already in here, we're going to take this little cutter, we're going to cut the butter into the flour, or the flour into the butter, however way you want to say it. This is going to take a little time. But I'll be right back as soon as I get it done. All right, guys. I've got it done. You see it's all the butter been cut in there. It's going to make for a good moist biscuit. So, all right. Now we're going to make us a little well in here. I'm going to pour 1 cup of buttermilk in it. All right. Take our spoon. We're just going to whisk our scrape from the sides and come in. I've learned here in Georgia, sometimes that 1 cup of buttermilk does not work. The humidity is real low today, and just ain't quite. If it dough's too dry, you can always add just a touch more milk in there. I think I'm going to add a touch. About that much. Probably not even a quarter of a cup. Paper. I'll be right back. All right, guys. Just kind of help with the mess. Of course, when you work with flour, it's going to go all over the place. So we'll add a little flour or parchment paper to help it keep it from sticking. And here we go, we'll turn this dough out. I may not have, should have added that extra milk, but that's okay. It's a weird sink. Excuse me. Now, I'm gonna get you hands, flired it pretty good, and just sprinkle a little bit on the top of the dough here. Now this is where you make biscuits or bricks. You don't want to handle this dough too much. It will get tough on you. And it's folded in on itself. Press it out, fold. Now, while I'm doing this, the oven has been preheating to 450. All right, it's starting to feel pretty good now. And all I do, I don't use a rolling pin. I just kind of mash it out in a square. I should have done this ahead of time. But you want to take your extra butter that you had, fire up or grease up the pan. Generally, I get 4 to 6 biscuits out of here. All right. We got our pan greased up now. So, all right. Take our biscuit cutter here. Wait a minute. I'm gonna make a little bitty biscuit. I think I'll use my cup. Make a bigger biscuit. What do you think? We're gonna go big tonight today. Alright, we got our flour, our dough, about a half inch thick. Just cut them out. Here you see, it's gonna make a biscuit. All right, we'll lay that in the pan. We'll get these things cut out. And I'll show them to you right here as soon as we get them cut out. All right, be right back, guys. Now when you get these cut out, you're going to have some extra dough. No problems. Just take it and just work it again. Get a little more flour here. And these may be just a touch tougher than the first batch we cut out, but I guarantee you it's gonna be good. All right. Well, look at that, them spots of butter in there. This one we'll just round him up. Flatten him out. I made room for this first time I've ever had 7 biscuits come out. You want to kind of put them close together so they'll rise up on each other. So, all right. These will go in the oven for about 10 to 12 minutes. We'll have some hot, fluffy buttermilk biscuits. All right, guys, we'll be right back with you. All right, guys, I think I'm going to fry some bacon up while these biscuits are cooking. So we'll let them cook. I might do an egg. I might do a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit this morning. Sounds pretty good. All right. I'll be right back. Bacon. Guys, we'll be right back. Look at that. Nice and man. Alright. One more step. Remember that butter we had? Just rub them all over the top of this, these biscuits. Goodness gracious. Some pretty biscuits. All right. You can hear that bacon sizzling in the background. We'll open this thing up. Oh man. All right. When that bacon gets done, I think I'm gonna fry an egg up too. So we'll be right back and through the magic of video, we'll have us a bacon, egg, and cheese buttermilk biscuit. Be right back, guys. Hey guys, there we have it. Buttermilk biscuit, bacon, egg, and cheese. So let's, man, mouse water. All right, guys. Let's try this bad boy out. Man, that thing's good. Light, fluffy. And I think we hit on something when we added the bacon soda to it, bacon powder, excuse me. But, made it a little bit fluffier. So, alright guys, you see how easy it was. I know if I can do it, you can do it. Hey guys.